this cat trying to sneak around. Focus. What's this problem? Anyways, I didn't come out here to film cats. I came out here to talk about chains. And I'll tell you the reason I want to talk about chains. My return trip from Boston, after I pulled in the driveway, one of these chains had fallen off my car. Like, it had unhooked, and it wasn't dragging on the road, so it had to have unhooked while I made a real sharp turn into the driveway. But that said, I'm going to couple that with a story that I have to tell you about work. We just the other day had somebody have their trailer come unhooked on the pintle, and they had to rely on the chains to hold it while they went out and sorted out the problem. It was user error. He didn't put a clasp through, he just relied on this, but again, as a pintle, so it's a different kind of situation. But chains are important. I'd been meaning to replace these chains, didn't get around to it right away, but the return of the chain falling off plus what just recently happened to a coworker means I need to get on this and put new chains on. So with a click of my finger, I'll show you what I've done. All right, and just like that, we've got new chains. You can see these have a little clasp here so that they won't fall off the rings, the D-rings or whatever they're called, on the back of my hitch receiver set up there. The chain is pretty thick. I've got a hardened grade 8 bolt going through with a nylon nut over here, so that shouldn't back out or anything. And when you compare it, this one had no clasp, which isn't vital, but obviously it fell off. And you compare the chain sizes, you can see that this one, the new one, is rated for a lot more. I know these are rated for 2,600 pounds. I think the chain is rated for 2,600. I don't know for sure, but I do know that if you have to rely on these, you're going to end up with a jolt, and you're going to want something strong enough and not so corroded to take that jolt and keep your trailer behind your vehicle. And one last thing before I, two last things. One thing is that, you know, when you get that feeling that you should do something and sometimes you regret that you didn't do something about it because something happens. I had a feeling about these chains, and I like to follow my gut instinct. Let's hope that this doesn't get relied upon, but with all the recent things that had happened and me thinking about them, now is the time to do something about it. That is a Harbor Freight jack. That wasn't part of the recall, but I don't rely on it to hold up anything other than the tongue of my trailer. So don't worry, I'm not putting this thing underneath vehicles. If you spotted that and think like I do, just so you know, it wasn't one of the recall jacks, A, and B, I don't put any major weight on it. So, all right, till the next video. Probably going to be going to Rhode Island, the Seekonk and Providence River in Godzilla. See you there. Just heading over to the trash to put these things in there. Probably hit the recycle now that I think about it. But look at how bent that bolt is. What the hell?